bad evil accusation again the children of God here. And when they put them inside fire, they saw God too immediately with them. That's why you, anything you are going through, God is always there for you. There can be problems in the church. It could be in your house. If you are a child of God, you are not one that you are really talking anyhow, God will be with you. If your hands are clean, no evil in your hand. That's why you need to bother yourself when they tell lies against you. Every child of God must go through its own problem. Look at Daniel. When Daniel was made a great man in the land of Babylon, they planned against him. In Daniel chapter 6 also, let's read it. He pleased Daniel from verse 1. Daniel chapter 6 from verse 1. He pleased Daniel to send over the kingdom and 120 princes, which would be over the whole kingdom, and over their three presidents, of whom Daniel was first, that the princes might give account unto them, and the king to have no Daniel. Then this Daniel was preferred above the president and prince, because an excellent spirit was in him, and he came down to set him over the whole land. Then the president and prince sought to find location against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could find no location nor fall. For as much as was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him. Then said his men, we shall not find any occasion against Daniel, except to find it against him concerning the law of his God. Why are they planning to bring Daniel down? Because he has an excellent spirit. But when you have the spirit of God, Satan will hate you. He will make trouble with you. It's only when you don't have anything inside you that in the church of God or anywhere, Satan will leave you alone. It is when you don't have the spirit of God in you that Satan will leave you alone. Because you know that already you go to hell with him. But when you have the spirit of God, excellent spirit of God, you will make trouble. That was what he did here with Daniel. So why are you complaining? As a child of God, that you have a problem. What you should just know is that God will see you through that problem. Every child of God must have his own problem. You remember our Lord Jesus Christ? He had his own problem. And when the problem came, he overcame. Remember that the people buried him, they thought that that was the end of the story. They put Jesus in safe grave. Because they don't want to hear about him again. And that's the worst thing they can do to anybody. Thank God they have not put you in safe grave. Even if they put you in safe grave, if the Lord says you rise, we rise. We have had cases of men of God, children of God who died, and in the mortuary, they came alive. There's nothing God cannot do. Look at when Jesus was put inside grave. Luke 24. I'm going to read from verse 1 to verse 6. Because so many challenges have come our way. That's why Jesus came to show us that if we can go through it, which will be able to go through it. his brethren, their watchword over him. The disciples of Jesus, they are not home. Even to the point that they went about going to do other businesses. Because they thought that it was the end of the ministry. What is there in heaven? Look at Luke 24, verse 1. Now, upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spice which they had prepared, and certain others to death. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were one perplexed yet about, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, why seek ye the living among the dead? Is not here, but is risen. Remember, I spake unto you when it was yet. Jesus Christ was now inside the grave. The disciples, there's nothing they can do. But see what happened on the third day. God raised him right from that room, that place where they put him. That's the power of God. I'm saying all this for you so that when the challenges come your way, you don't lose hope. A ministry like this, you know, we are trying to correct ourselves. We are trying to make people to walk in the path of God now. Because today, the world is lost. They are now, everybody is running from the way of Satan. And when we come here, it is when you are hearing the word to be correcting you and be correcting yourself. And there will be some of these people who are coming in who are not completely been free from their evil way. They may offend you. Don't do so. Know that God is there and He will see you through. But if your hearts are not clean, God will not go into your trouble with you. Every child of God that has trouble, God has always been there with them. Every child of God, when they have problems, God has always entered into that problem with them. And He always delivered them from that problem. Even when Peter, in the book of Acts chapter 12, when he entered into his own problem. And when you are looking at people who are entering into a problem, they are great men of God, somebody like Peter. If people like that can enter into trouble, why don't you enter into trouble? If you don't enter into trouble with the Pharisees, why is your mind hard? Why don't you enter into trouble? But the guarantee is that God will see us through. So that's why you don't have to fight for yourself. You don't have to be saying things that you, why is it me? What is this problem? Let it come, if we go. In Acts chapter 12, let's see the case of Peter here. I will read from verse 5. Peter therefore was kept in prison, but prayer was made in season of the church unto God for him. And when Aaron would have brought him forth, the same night, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with chains, and the keeper before the door kept the prison. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and light shined in the prison. And he smote Peter on the side and raised him up, saying, arise up quickly. And his chains fell off from his hand. And the angel said unto him, guard thyself and and bind on thy sandal. And so it be, and he said unto him, cast thy garment about thee, and follow me. And he went out, and followed him, and with one that was true, which was not an angel, but thought he saw a vision. Verse 10, when they were past the first and the second world, they came unto the iron gate that leadeth into the city, which opened to them of his own accord. And they went out and passed on through one street, and forthwith the angel departed from me. Verse 11, and when Peter was come to himself, he said, now I know of a surety that the Lord has sent angels and has delivered me